a viral video, and a stolen tip jar. Here's what's coming up next on Trend Spotting. Hop it, everyone. I'm Cami Aguirola, and welcome back to another episode of Trend Spotting. Here are the topics that had you talking this week, starting with a video that has gone viral. He told police his last name was Immaculate Conception and his home address is Earth. His real name, however, is Jobert Boiser Carlos, and he was the man in a viral video who appeared to have been punched by a police officer while being cuffed and placed in a police car. A lifeguard said around noon on Tuesday at the Ipao Beach Park, Carlos tried to assault him. He was calling out other people to fight and was swinging punches at random people. On the way to the patrol car, court documents state Carlos thrust himself back towards the officer and kicked the rear bumper of the patrol car. The officer then conducted an open palm strike to Carlos's abdomen to gain compliance and placed him back into the patrol car. While being transported to the Tumuning precinct, Carlos allegedly repeatedly kicked the metal cage in the patrol car. Carlos was charged with criminal mischief, assault, and disorderly conduct. As for the officer in the viral video, the FBI is conducting a civil rights investigation, while the AG's office has been asked by GPD Chief Steve Ignacio to lead the criminal investigation. Here are some of your comments from the viral video. One Instagram user said, "Unacceptable. The individual is already down. Give him some dignity. We don't need brutality. That's why GPD doesn't get the respect because of unacceptable professional behavior." Another Instagram user said, "In my observation, I noticed the guy not walking straight and the officer had to pull him back towards the car. And second, blocked by the fine lifeguard, you can see the guy's leg coming down as if he just kicked the squad car. Not the best way of going about the situation, but it doesn't look entirely uncalled for." On Facebook, Teresita Rodriguez said, "These cops think they're above the law. Take away their badges and let them do jail time for assault. Get with the program, Governor. We want justice before this gets out of hand." Another Facebook user said, "Even if you were to show the full video, that cop would still be in the wrong. The punch in the gut was absolutely unnecessary given the fact that the dude has already been handcuffed. Plain and simple, do not get me wrong. I have the utmost respect for my brothers and sisters in blue, but I get it. There's always going to be a few bad apples in the basket. Shame on this officer for conduct so below those of his fellow brothers and sisters in blue." Up next, video surveillance from a restaurant shows a man stealing a tip jar.
He came in for lumpia and left with $80 in tips that weren't his. Somai and Yigo was robbed, and the surveillance video shows the suspect. Lauren Regis, who works at Somai, told KOAM that she and a coworker were getting ready to close the restaurant when a man came in. Reyes said the man made off with $80 in tips that workers were going to split at the end of their shift. She described the suspect as possibly being in his 40s, dark complexion, short hair, and wearing a blue hat. Her advice to the people of Guam as they suffer from a crime wave: always be careful, and it's always good to have cameras. On Instagram, our followers took to the comments. One Instagram user said, "The holidays, guys. I know it's hard for all, but this isn't the right way. God is the right way. This is his month. Why don't we just ask him or reach for him instead of an $80 tip jar?" Another Instagram user, the_frankofficial, said, "That's messed up to take people's income like that, because that jar represents more than just extra money. That jar of cash is reflective of the customer service and food quality of that place. $80 is a lot of hard work for a small business. I hope someone reads this and is inspired to support local economy and show love by eating a meal and leaving a small something extra, and take some pics and give these guys some social media love." Frank Patrick Itasi was arrested for the beating and robbing of an elderly woman at Bajado's barbershop on Thanksgiving morning. According to the filings, he admitted to the crime, saying he had just lost money while playing machines at a game room. He went inside the Bajado barbershop, saw the woman, hit her multiple times, and stole $900. The victim suffered serious injuries and was transported to the Guam Regional Medical Facility. It was through CCTV footage, witnesses, and tips from the community that detectives from the criminal investigation section managed to identify the suspect through a photo lineup. He was charged with first-degree robbery with a special allegation of vulnerable victim, theft of property, felonious restraint, and strangulation. Here are some of your comments. Evangeline M. Cepeda said, "Shame on him," while another Instagram user said, "I hope the victim and her family will get some justice. Good job to the community for helping." At Peter_Diego671 said, "This is just sick. To do something like this on Thanksgiving morning. I hope this guy gets what he deserves."
KOAM would like to thank all its participants in Giving Tuesday.
On Tuesday, KUAM, with the help of various schools, businesses, and organizations, took part in Giving Tuesday, an international day of giving. This year, our team collected donations from our partners in the community. We want to give a huge thank you to M80 Office Systems, Manyelu, Papa John's, Synergy Studios, the Guam National Basketball Team, Payless Supermarkets, Southern High School, Mount Carmel School, Ambrose Inc., Upi Elementary School, and Finnegayan Elementary School for their donations that will go to Guam's children in need. Without your generous contributions and sacrifice, none of this would be possible. The effort doesn't end here, though. If you would like to learn more about how you can assist with future events of this type, please follow us on Instagram at Giving Tuesday Guam and at KOAM Communications.
That's all for this week's episode of TrendSpotting. Sidus Maasi for watching, and I'll see you next time.